Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. This is lecture number 11.3. Here we are going to solve problems in the brake design. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the theory part of brake design. And in this lecture, we will solve problems in the block brake, differential band brake, and the internal expanding shoe brake. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the block brake, differential band brake, and the internal expanding brake. The first example from November 2006 and May 2007 question paper. In a single block brake, the diameter of the drum is 250 millimeter and the angle of contact is 90 degree. The operating force is 700 Newton is applied at the end of the lever, which is at 250 millimeter from the center of the brake block. The coefficient of friction between the drum and the lining is 0.35. Determine the torque that may be transmitted. The fulcrum is 200 millimeter from the center of the block and an offset of 50 millimeter from the surface of the contact. So this is the single block brake. Here in the example, the direction of rotation is not given. So we consider both the cases, clockwise rotation as well as the anti-clockwise direction. And this is the single block brake, and the O is the fulcrum and the A is the offset distance. And this is the center of the brake block, and L is the total length of the lever. And X is the position of the center of the block from the fulcrum O. The data given, the radius of the brake drum R equal to 0.125 meter. We are given diameter, we take the radius, 2 theta equal to 90 degree. X, the distance of the fulcrum from the center of the block is 0.2 meter. Length of the lever, X plus the balance distance from the center of the block up to the point of the load force application. So 0.2 plus 0.25 equal to 0.45 meter, and the A offset equal to 0.05 meter, and the P is the pressure, P is the operating force, which is 700 Newton, and the mu equal to 0.35. So since the angle of contact 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we have to correct the coefficient of friction. So mu dash equal to 4 mu sin theta divided by 2 theta plus sin 2 theta. So substituting the numerical values, 4 into 0.35 into sin 45 divided by pi into 90 divided by 180. So we have to substitute theta in radians. So pi into 90 divided by 180 plus sin 90 equal to 0.385. So this mu dash is to be used in all the calculations. The braking torque when the drum rotates in the clockwise direction. So TB equal to mu into PL divided by X minus mu A into R is the R is the radius of the brake drum. So substituting numerical values, mu equal to 0.385 into 700 into 0.45 divided by 0.2 minus 0.385 into 0.05 into 0.125 equal to 83.87 Newton meter. Then the braking torque when the drum rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. So TB equal to mu into PL divided by X plus mu A into radius R. So TB equal to substitute numerical values 0.385 into 700 into 0.45 divided by 0.2 plus 0.385 into 0.05 into 0.125 equal to 69.14 Newton. So this is the braking torque for both the clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. Example number 2. So this is from May 2016 question paper. A single block brake as shown in the figure has a drum diameter 250 millimeter. So the radius is marked as 125 millimeter. The angle of contact is 90 degree and the coefficient of friction between the drum and the lining is 0.35. If the torque transmitted by the brake is 80 Newton meter, find the force required to operate the brake. So now you have to calculate the P. And the distance are given. So this is the O is the fulcrum, this is the center of the brake, and we have offset of 50 millimeter, the total length of the lever equal to 450 millimeter. So the data given, R equal to 0.125, radius equal to 0.125, 2 theta equal to 90 degree, mu equal to 0.35, TB equal to 80 Newton meter, XC equal to 0.2 meter, L equal to 0.45 meter, and A equal to 0.05 meter. Now, this is the corresponding diagram. So, X, C, L, A, everything, we can compare the diagram and write down the given data. Now, the angle of contact, 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we have to correct the coefficient of friction. So, mu dash equal to 4 mu sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine 2 theta equal to 4 into 0.35 into sine 45 divided by pi into 90 divided by 180. So, we have to substitute theta in radians. So, plus sine 90 equal to 0.385. So, breaking torque when the drum rotates in the clockwise direction. So, the equation TB equal to mu into PL divided by X minus mu A into R. So, TB, the breaking torque is given 80 Newton meter. We substitute the values in the right hand side. So, 0.385 into P into 0.45. So, P is the unknown, the force is unknown here, divided by 0.2 minus 0.385 into 0.05 into 0.125. So, left hand side as it is 80. Right hand side simplify, it is 0.1198 into P. So now the force required is 667.7 Newton. So the force required to operate the brake P equal to 667.7 Newton. Example number 3 from November 2013 question paper. So this is the double block brake. The figures shows a double shoe brake capable of absorbing 17.5 kilowatt. The drum diameter is 500 millimeter and rotates at 1200 rpm. Coefficient of friction between the brake drum and the lining is 0.36. Find 1. The spring force necessary to set the brake. Dimension of the brake shoe taking allowable pressure of the friction lining as 0.156 megapascal. So the diagram is given in the question paper. So, I just represented the various forces acting on the brake drum. The block of the brake, we have the normal reaction and the force. So, the drum is rotating in the clockwise direction. So, F1 is the force acting in the downward direction. F2 is the force acting in the upward direction. And N2 is the reaction on the left side. And O1, O2, they are the fulcrum. And the distance of fulcrum from the center of the drum is 60 millimeter on either side. And here, the distance of the spring, S, from the fulcrum, 330 millimeter to the center, and above the center to the location of the spring, it is 390 millimeter, and the angle 2 theta equal to 120 degree. So, these are all the given data, power equal to 17.5 kilowatt, N speed equal to 1200 rpm, radius equal to 0.25 meter. We are given diameter of the drum, we take radius equal to 0.25 meter. Coefficient of friction is 0.36 and the pressure, the allowable pressure is 0.156 megapascal. Since the angle of contact 2 theta is greater than 90 degree, we have to calculate mu dash. So, mu dash equal to 4 mu sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine 2 theta. So, this is 4 into 0.36 into sine 60 divided by pi into 120 divided by 180. So, to substitute the theta in radians plus 120. Sine 120 equal to 0.4241. So, mu dash, the coefficient of friction is 0.4241. So, this is the value we have to use for further calculation in all the calculations. The spring force necessary to set the brake. First, we take the block 1, taking the moment about the O1. So, moment about the O1, F1 into distance 0.125 into 0.06 plus N1 into distance 0.33. Plus S into distance 0.33 plus 0.39. So, look at the diagram. So, F1 into distance, the point of action is equal to from the fulcrum 0.125, the radius of the brake drum minus 0.06. So, F1 into 0.125 minus 0.06, N1 into the height 0.33 and S into the distance 0.33 plus 0.39. So, that is the calculation here. So, F1 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus N1 into 0.33 equal to S into 0.33 plus 0.39. So, first term as it is, second term N1 equal to F1 by mu. So, into 0.33 plus S into all these values. Now, F1 is substitute the mu equal to 0.4241. So, simplifying F1 into 0.065 plus F1 into 0.783 is equal to 0.72 into S. So rearranging, F1 equal to 0.849 into S. So the force F1 equal to 0.849 into spring force S. Similarly for block 2, taking the moment about the fulcrum O2, F2 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus S into 0.33 plus 0.39 equal to N2 into 0.33. So once again, substitute N2 equal to F2 by mu. So calculating F2 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus S into 0.33 plus 0.39 equal to F2 by mu into 0.33. So simplifying, F2 into 0.065 minus F2 into 0.783 plus 0.72 S equal to 0. So 0.718 F2 equal to 0.72 S. So F2 equal to 1.003 S. So the braking torque, so from the power given, you have to calculate the braking torque. So braking torque equal to power into 60 divided by 2 pi n, 17,500 into 60 divided by 2 into 3.14 into 1200 equal to 139.33 Newton meter. Then the spring force necessary to set the brake, Mt equal to F1 plus F2 into S. So F1 in terms of the spring force, 0.849 S. F2 in terms of spring force, 1.003 S into 0.25 equal to 0.463 into S. So solving, S, the spring force equal to 300.9 Newton. Next, we have to calculate the dimensions of the brake shoe. So for that, we have to calculate the normal reaction, N1 equal to F1 by mu. So this equal to 0.849 into 300.9 divided by 0.4214 equal to 606.23 Newton. And F2 equal to, N2 equal to F2 by mu, 1.003 into 300.9 divided by 0.4214 equal to 716.19 Newton. So the pressure and width of the brake line, friction lining, so P equal to, pressure P equal to normal reaction divided by the frictional bearing area. So normal reaction, the highest value we have to take, N2 is the highest value, N2 divided by 2W R into sin theta. So R sin theta into W is the area into 2. So rearranging, W equal to N2 divided by 2P into R sin theta. So the W equal to, N2 is 716.19 divided by 2 into P equal to 0.156 into 10 power 6, R equal to 0.25 into sin 60. This equal to 0.106 meter, which is 1.06 centimeter. So width of the friction lining is 1.06 centimeter. So the answer to the problem, the spring force necessary to set the brake is 300.9 Newton and width of the brake shoe is 1.06 centimeter. Example number 4 from November 2007 question paper. Again, here the layout of a double block brake is shown in the figure. The brake is rated at 250 Newton meter at 650 RPM. Rated power equal to torque equal to 250 Newton meter and the speed equal to 650 RPM. The drum diameter is 250 millimeter, assuming coefficient of friction to be 0.3. And for conditions of service, a PV, the pressure into velocity equal to 1000 kilopascal meter per second may be assumed. Determine the spring force required to set the brake and width of the shoes. Which shoe will have greater rate of wear and what will be the ratio of rates of wear of the two shoes? So this is the diagram given here, and we write down the given data. Torque equal to 250 Newton meter, speed equal to 650 RPM, radius of the drum equal to 0.125 meter, coefficient of friction is 0.3, the pressure into velocity, linear velocity equal to 1000 kilopascal meter per second. And other dimensions are given here, 160 millimeter spring force acting at a distance of 160 plus 160, 320 millimeter. O1, O2 are the fulcrum at a distance of 60 millimeter from the center. And F1 is the force acting here, N1 is the normal reaction, F2 is the force acting here, and N2 is the normal reaction. The angle 2 theta equal to 110 degrees. Now, since the angle of contact 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we calculate mu dash. So, mu dash equal to 4 mu sin theta divided by 2 theta plus sin 2 theta. which is 4 into 0.3 into sine 55 divided by pi into 110 divided by 180 plus sine 110 equal to 0.3438. Now the spring force required to set the brake. First we have to calculate the F1, F2 value. For calculating F1, for block 1, taking moment about O1. So F1 into 0.125 in minus 0.06 into plus N1 into 0.16 plus S into 0.16 plus 0.16. So this N1 equal to F1 by mu. So substituting F1 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus F1 by mu into 0.16 into S in equal to S into 0.32. Substituting for mu 3438. So F1 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus F1 by 0.3438 into 0.16 equal to S into 0.32. Simplifying, F1 into 0.065 plus F1 into 0.465 equal to 0.32 times of S. So F1 equal to 0.06038 S. S is the spring force. F1 is the force on the block 1. Then similarly for the block 2, taking the moment about O2, F2 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus S into 0.16 plus 0.16 equal to N2 into 0.16. This N2 equal to F2 by mu. So F2 into 0.125 minus 0.06 plus S into 0.32 equal to F2 by mu into 0.16. So substituting for mu 0.3438. So F2 into 0.065 minus F2 into 0.465 plus 0.32 S equal to 0. So 0.4 F2 equal to 0.32 S. So F2 equal to 0.8 times of S. Now the spring force necessary to set the brake, MT equal to F1 plus F2 into R. So 250 Newton meter is given in the problem. 250 equal to 0.6038 into S plus 0.8 into S into 0.125, which is 0.175 S. So S equal to 1428.6 Newton. The spring force equal to 1428.6 Newton. Now normal reaction you have to calculate, N1 equal to F1 by mu. So 0.6038 into 1428.6 divided by 0.3438 equal to 2509 Newton, and N2 equal to F2 by mu. So 0.8 into 1428.6 divided by 0.3438 equal to 3324.2 Newton. The ratio of rate of wear between the two shoes, N1 by N2 equal to 2509 divided by 3324.2 equal to 0.755. And linear velocity we calculate, V equal to pi d n by 60. So n is the speed, 3.14 into 0.25 into 60 divided by 60 equal to 8.504 meter per second. And the braking, the pressure on the brake lining. So PV, we are given PV value. So from that we calculate P equal to 10 power 6 divided by 8.504 equal to 117,591.7 newtons per meter square. That is the pressure on the brake lining. Then the width of the friction lining, P equal to normal reaction divided by the bearing area. So normal reaction, we take the highest value, N2 divided by 2WR into sin theta. So rearranging, W equal to N2 divided by 2PR into sin theta. So substitute numerical values, W equal to 3324.2 divided by 2 into 117,591.7 into 0.125 into sin 55 equal to 0.138 equal to 13.8 centimeter. So the answer to the problem, the spring force necessary to set the brake, 1428.6 Newton, width of the brake shoe 13.8 centimeter. Left block shoe will have more wear, and the wear ratio is 0.755. So these are all the answer to the problem. Example number 5 from May 2013 question paper. In a band and block brake, the band is limited with 14 blocks, each of which subtend an angle of 20 degree at the drum center. One end of the band is attached to the fulcrum of the brake lever and the other end other to the pin of 150 mm from the fulcrum. Find the force required at the end of the lever 1 meter long from the fulcrum to give a torque of 4 kN meter. The diameter of the brake drum equal to 1 meter and the coefficient of friction between the blocks and the drum is 0.25. and this is the diagram. We have T1, T2 are the tension on the band. A is the point, so O is the fulcrum. A is the other end of the band. Total length of the lever 1 meter, and the other end of the band is 150 millimeter, that is 0.15 meter from the fulcrum. So this is again another diagram. So we have a block. Each block has obtained an angle of 20 degree. 2 theta equal to 20 degree, and these are all the forces. Normal force T1 dash T1 and the mu into Rn. So mu into Rn acting horizontally, and Rn normal reaction acting vertically. And the T1 is the force on the tight side. T1 dash is the tension on the slack side. And the T1 is the tension on the slack side, and T2 is the tension on the tight side. So T2 is the tension on the tight side. This is the tight side, this is the slack side. So we are given n equal to 14, number of blocks equal to 14, theta equal to 10 degree. So 2 theta equal to 20 degree. So theta equal to 10 degree. Diameter d equal to 1 meter. That is r radius equal to 0.5 meter. Coefficient of friction is 0.25, and the breaking torque equal to 4 kilonewton meter. So assume this drum is rotating clockwise direction. Tension T1 is on the T1 is the tight side, and T2 is the T1 is the slack side, and T2 is the tight side. And so this is the diagram once again. Ratio of the tension T1 by T2 for number of blocks, more number of blocks. So 1 plus mu tan theta, it will be 1 minus mu tan theta to the power n. So 1 plus 0.25 tan 10, it will be 1 minus 0.25 tan 10 to the power 14 equal to 3.4387. And tension on the tight end, the slack side of the band, the breaking torque TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So breaking torque is given as 4000 equal to 3.4387 T2 minus T2 into 0.5. So this value from T1 by T2 equal to 3.4787, substitute for T1. So this becomes 1.21935 T2. So T2 equal to 3280 Newton. And T1 equal to 3.4387 into T2. So 3.4387 into 3280 equal to 11,279 Newton. So T1 equal to 11,279 Newton, and T2 equal to 3280 Newton. Now taking moment about O from the fulcrum, the force required at the end of the lever, P into OB. So P into OB, O into B, OB the total distance, length of the lever, equal to T1 into OA, T1 into OA. So P into 1, the total length is 1 meter, T1 equal to 11,279 and OA equal to 0.15. So the P, the force required equal to 1,692 Newton. So this is the answer to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. You can subscribe the YouTube channel. You will get all the video lectures about the, in all the subjects, you will get the video lectures. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any details with my mail ID. We'll meet again in next video with additional problems on the brake design.